I'd like to welcome Ashton Desmond, Kerry fullback and All-Star in 2015, to chat to us today a little bit about football and about your job and I suppose everything that goes on for you in your general life. So let's start at the beginning in Rathmore. How did you start playing football way back when?
So I originally started when I was, I'd say, 7 or 8 with the club. My father was the trainer of the Rathmore ladies and Rathmore's a really small place, so he kind of like dragged me along to go fill the numbers and things, and that was really how I started.
And did your sister play as well?
Yeah, Katrina played my sister. She would have been like the main footballer in the family. She still plays with the club now and things. She doesn't play for the county now anymore.
And athletics was your thing, was it?
Growing up, I always did athletics. So I did athletics with Ginninguilla, which would be the next club to Rathmore.
Yeah.
I did that. Was in Mosnave, 5 goals.
Any particular discipline that you enjoyed most?
100 meter sprint.
Yeah. And when did you kind of think, okay, maybe football, I like this, or I might give it a bit more attention?
I think that it was probably when we were in secondary school, just after the primary games. And like I really enjoyed like a team sport and like playing with other people, and it's really good even as like a friendship, building up friends, like within the club and the county as well. And like winning good as well was a big thing. It's just a competitive streak just to kind of keep that going. And kind of started playing the county then from 14s up along it.
And did you ever think about pursuing athletics?
Not really, no. I kind of preferred football. Like once I got a bit older, I kind of preferred just the more team sport as opposed to individual sport. You can get a bit lonely after a while. I preferred a team sport definitely.
And it was 2012. You had a very good year with the club.
Yeah, that was the. Sorry, 2015 was the
2015.
Club. Yeah, and we won the senior championship in Kerry. So then we obviously went on to represent Kerry in Munster, which was fantastic because Rathmore is such a small place. And
how small? Excuse my geography now. How small are we talking? How many shops?
There'd be two sides to Rathmore.
Right. Okay.
Yeah, big Rathmore, small Rathmore, but it's only a little village, like that would have been massive for the club, and it was such an honour because it wouldn't really be heard of that, such small village.
Was your dad involved?
No, dad actually wasn't our trainer. No, he was only our trainer underage now, so thankfully he stepped down with the right pressure.
I'd say he was really excited though.
Oh yeah, no, dad was thrilled, when you win those kind of things, it's more for your family and your friends, just winning with the girls than anything, And even like the Rathmore as a community, I remember from day one, we came back to the village and there was massive bonfires and all the families were there. Yeah, it was fantastic.
And tell us a bit about when you went to UL, didn't you?
Yeah, I went to UL then.
I did
Arts and Public Administration, so I was there for 4 years. Loved Limerick, fantastic, great place.
Was it a big change from Rathmore to Limerick?
Yeah, I suppose it was. I remember the first day I went to UL, it was so daunting because it was so big compared to secondary school. But I suppose public administration is kind of like a smaller class, so you kind of get to know everyone in your class and things.
And what's the gist of public administration?
So basically it's politics and economics and business, and then you can do an elective, so extended marketing. So yes, good.
And where did that take you then?
I went working for Kerry Group for 4 years. I worked in the purchasing department. That was fantastic. Kerry Group is such a brilliant organisation to work for. There's they love travel and they're really good with sport, helping me out with sports and things, because they're obviously our sponsor for Kerry Ladies. That was good. It was a good way to show initiative. They were meant to really show initiative within
So I suppose from a career point of view,
absolutely.
You learned
a lot. I definitely learned a lot working for Kerry Group.
And where were you based?
I was based in Tralee in the head office for 2 years, and then I got moved to Dublin for the last 2 years.
And what was that like when you were in Dublin?
It was it was a bit difficult, I suppose, for football and things, but I actually trained with Foxrock MT League,
right.
So Pat Reed was my trainer.
Oh,
but
very good. Yeah. So that would have been a high standard.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely. Oh my God, their setup is fantastic. It's nearly like a county setup because they have Cat and Peter, you know, and like they're very professional. Like they're even so successful as a senior club.
Yeah.
Like, should they have a final?
And how was the travel then? How did you balance that?
Yeah, that was difficult. All right. I traveled down on the Wednesday for training and traveled back up Wednesday night, traveled back down Friday, and back up on Sunday. So you were, I suppose, on the road at night, special.
A challenge, yeah.
Yeah, that was
a challenge. And you've since left Kerry Group.
Yeah.
Where are you?
Now I'm working in Tralee in a bank called GRI America.
Right, so that's obviously a lot closer to home.
Yeah.
How
is
that working in football?
So they're fantastic, supporting me with football. They're very accommodating for even for training wise and things. Like, I literally train in the IT, so it's right behind where I work, which is really handy for like the commute is now the smallest, I think, less than a minute.
Yeah, yeah. So lifestyle wise,
yeah, absolutely. Like, as in, you get to go to a gym and I mean, like, you're not rushing and racing now as much and you're not on the road, so like you've plenty of time to recover, and just as a lifestyle, it's like it's a lot easier now.
And tell us about I know that the garage and the Peugeot garage in Lathmore gave you a sponsored car. When did that start?
So that started in 2016. So this is my second year of it now. So
and who approached you there?
So Peugeot Ireland will have approached say Orlick the garage thing just to in Lathmore. They also sponsor another Kerry senior men footballer, Paul Murphy, who's from the village as well. So that was a huge honour, being asked to be brand ambassador for Peugeot.
Yeah.
Just because it would be kind of unheard of within the ladies scene.
It's probably one of the first person to get it.
I actually think it was one of the first, but that was lovely.
And how did you feel driving around on that with your name on it and stuff like that?
Well, I suppose it was such an honour actually, to be very honest about it. Everybody would know your car.
That's the
one thing.
Couldn't ride in red lights.
No, definitely not.
I see. And so 2012, we played in the championship, and you beat us
5 points.
5 points. It's great day out for the Ducks. But that year you went on to play Cork.
So
I suppose you played Cork all the time, and the championship and all that. And what was it like then, meeting them in Croke Park?
I just remember it was just such an occasion. Going to Croke Park and like the preparation, and it was just like so daunting. I remember when we were going out onto the pitch, and like the big cheer, like the kids, it was nearly you couldn't hardly hear the trainer on the side like giving you instructions in. I just thought the noise was totally different from
a different environment.
Definitely, yeah. Like,
did you have a lot of past players involved that year? Some past players, okay, players come back.
Max Dunho, Max Dunho came back that summer.
Okay. And were there other past players on the sideline? Water girls or something.
Yeah, in fair, like that has happened 2 years ago now. Louise Galvin came to the Munster final against Cork, and George Carden as well, which is great. Like, because I mean, like, they've such a knowledge of football, and like they know the players, and I mean, like, they could just give you instructions in, and it would be like on point, basically. So, and like they have such a football mind that you trust them. You know, because they would see things that you wouldn't.
And how do you feel that final went? It was Cork won. I suppose the general ambition in Kerry, we're there in 2012, it's now 2017. What's the ambition, or what's your ambition?
So the main objective this year definitely is to win the All-Ireland. We have a new trainer now this year, Bear Chine. Fantastic. We have a new physical coach, Kieran McCabe. So like, it's very professional this year, and it's very focused, and I mean, it's all eyes on Munster, and then hopefully the All-Ireland.
And do you think that, so he started this year, that manager?
This year, yeah.
Is it a kind of couple of years and you're going to stick around it and keep pushing on and keep pushing on?
I don't know, we'll be pushing on a couple of years because the older players are pushing on too. But Noah's definitely focused on this year, and he's really positive, and it's very fresh this year because there was a lot of minor girls in now as well, which is great for like numbers, trainings, competition for places and things now. So it's very good this year.
It's very good. And you were just nominated on Team of the League for league performances. I suppose that's a good start to your personal year.
Absolutely. Like, our league was up and down with some wins and then obviously some losses. It was unfortunate to lose against Mayo to go on to the semis, but the league was just a bit up and down for us. But hopefully now, like, we were playing Waterford in the Championship, which fortunately we lost, but we've Cork now in 2 weeks, so it's focused on that now for the next 2 weeks.
And just to finish up, I suppose, you work in marketing. And you know, you've seen the individual benefits of more attention to the ladies' game, to your car, and you're just up for the lead team of the league. Obviously, the league sponsorship has changed things. From a marketing point of view and your knowledge, how do you see things having changed in the last couple of years?
Well, I think that's
gone for ladies football.
Like, I definitely think that there is way more recognition within football, and I think that Lidl have done fantastic work, like highlighting it and. Like sponsoring the girls and things like that has been brilliant. And even like say a new little store opened in Clare or in Tralee, and like say me and Bobby really opened the store, like they're really, really pushing it now, which, you know, which is fantastic, and bringing recognition to our ladies football, which is good because we train just as hard as the men. And
do you think the live coverage of the TG Cahir makes a big difference for
us? Absolutely,
from
yeah, definitely. I think the team, like TG Cahir, have done great, like showing the, like, even like the league final and things like that. You know, in the championship latter games.
Yeah.
It's been wonderful.
Great. Ashton, thanks a million for joining us today.